Ghostlight Productions and the Goldwell Open Air Museum present Albert Szukalski's America. Produced in association with Nevada Humanities and the Nevada Arts Council and recorded at Elko Broadcasting Company. This recording is based on real people and events. However, some events and people are fictionalized and or have been exaggerated and altered. Any fictionalized characters that resemble living or dead people is purely coincidental.
The following production has been rated PG-13.
In 1904, Frank Shorty Harris and Ernest L. Cross discovered gold in the Armagosa Valley of Nevada. By 1908, the mining boomtown of Rhyolite was founded near their claim and boasted several thousand residents. But by 1915, the gold was played out. A once bustling town had only 20 souls left. By mid-century, it was a ghost town. In 1984, Belgium sculptor Albert Szukalski arrived at the ruins of Rhyolite to add a few more ghosts of his own devising.
Maestro, you may begin.
My name is Albert Szukalski, and this is my America, man.
Hello, everyone. I am assuming you are all here to learn about the one and only and handsome Albert Szukalski. My name is Monique, and I am Albert's wife and biggest fan. So none better to ask than me, allez? After all, he was my handsome Jim Morrison, and I his muse. Our dear star was born in Poland in 1945, and came out of the womb smoking a cigarette and holding a cold bud. That was Albert's favorite expression for beer. He became a well-known sculptor in Belgium and eventually in 1984 ventured off to the desert of Nevada to install perhaps his biggest art project ever. Albert had been a free spirit since birth and was known for a lot of his eccentric behaviors in Belgium even from an early age. That's why I fell in love with him. Let us visit Albert when he was younger and up to one of his more innovative activities on the streets of Antwerp.
Ladies and gentlemen of Antwerp, come on, and come on, and get your pop stones while you can. That's right, stones that the Pope himself has walked on.
Madam, would you like to own a stone that the Pope himself has walked on? Here is your chance. Here is your piece of salvation. Come on now, I will sell them to you for a fair price. After all, what is the price of redemption?
Get away from me, you lunatic!
Ow! Oh! Never mind! You are going, madam. No popstones can help you!
Sir? Would you like to own your very own popstone?
What is a popstone?
What is a popstone? Why, it is a stone that the Pope himself has stepped on. It is divine. It has been blessed with the Holy Spirit.
The true Pope himself?
Your God is my witness.
My! Oh, I will take one. Thank you.
Oh, no, you are welcome, my friend. God bless you.
As you can see, Albert always saw the world a little differently than others. The world was always a little brighter, more adventurous, and full of opportunity for him. Now, my love was already a well-known sculptor in Europe. But while on a trip to Death Valley, he had the sudden inspiration to make a monumental statement, the Last Supper. He decided that the vast and beautiful Death Valley desert was the perfect spot for his next sculpture project. The desert of Nevada resembled the desert of the Holy Land and held its own beauty and mystery. Unfortunately, the Death Valley National Park was having none of it, so a friend helped him locate another property in the ghost town of Rhyolite. However, like the empty desert, Albert too found himself a little lonely and longing for connection at first. He usually didn't have any trouble making friends, or girlfriends for that matter. But the American disposition is a little different. He met one of his soon-to-be best friends in, where else, a bar in Las Vegas.
Here you go, sir.
Thank you. And tell me, do you know who that man is over there?
Which man?
That man right there.
The one staring at you?
Yes.
Sorry, I do not. But he doesn't look very happy about us talking about him.
Oh, sure he does.
Okay, now you're waving at him. I'll be back.
Hi, can I help you?
I don't know, maybe. We all can use a little help, no?
What do you mean by that?
I mean, I don't want anything more than what every man desires.
Listen.
Albert.
I know that this is Viva Las Vegas and all, but you're barking up the wrong tree if you think that everyone here is into that free-loving lifestyle.
You Americans, man. So Puritan. No, listen. No, you are a very pretty man.
John?
But you see, I am much more interested in a more platonic company.
Uh-huh.
I have just come here from Belgium to work, and I find myself without any company of any kind. No one to talk to.
Well, head down to Fremont Street. I'm sure you'll find plenty of more company down there. Hey, bartender?
What, we cannot talk over one cold butt? I promise, I will not bore you.
And I promise you that I'm not in the mood for company. Besides, that's, what, your second beer?
Oh.
I doubt you'd be able to keep up with me anyways.
A challenge, then. Fantastic! Accepted!
Whatever.
Here's your beer. Thanks.
Oh, my friend! One more cold bud for me as well.
Bartender?
Yeah, my man!
Yes, gentlemen?
Oh, I called you over here first. Another.
No, I believe that I did.
You see, my friend here is trying to impress me. I'll have another. Oh, and one more for my friend here. Perhaps you have a baby bottle in the back that you could serve it in.
Oh, great! Then afterwards, I can shove it up your ass.
And I thought you Americans were into the free-loving lifestyle here.
Here, you beers.
Cheers to my new friend, John.
I am not your friend.
We shall see about that.
And on it went like that, 4 hours. Yes, a competition between men. Not of wits or strength or even skill, but of liver failure.
So you're going to put some damn ghosts in the desert. What in the hell is wrong with you?
I want to be a star, man.
You are something, all right.
No, it's an expression, man. One of my greatest works to date.
Well, make sure you get it right. You don't want to make a boo. Boo!
You!
Me?
Come out with me.
No.
Come with me to the desert, my friend. I could use the extra pair of hands.
To do what?
Help me make art. What else?
Art? Me help you make art? I can't even draw stick figures. Here, you see that menu? Here, give me that menu. Let me show you the extent of my artistic abilities. Hold on, all right. So you make sure that you get a very... There you go. You need someone to create a dick? Well, here I am!
It is the finest penis I have ever seen in my life.
Thank you.
Yes. You are Leonardo Dick Vinci!
Prick! Picasso!
The great Vincent Van Gogh!
Oh, man!
Soon, John and Albert became, how do you say, thick as thieves. The year was 1984, and an artistic renaissance in Rhyolite was about to start.
Where are the models?
I'm sure they'll be here soon.
Oh, they are friends of yours, huh? They should have more respect for being on time.
Ah, yes. Says the man who refuses to wear watches or abide by anyone else's time.
Nevertheless, it will get too hot soon. We need to start now.
Calm down, all right? Why is there a bee in your bonnet this morning?
What are you saying to me, huh? There are no bees here. I am not wearing a bonnet.
It's an expression. Listen, everything's going to work out just fine.
From your pictures you've showed me, you could probably do work in a snowstorm and it would turn out amazing. How'd you get started making these ghosts anyways?
Actually, one morning I asked my wife, "Do you have an extra pair of sheets?" And she did.
That's it?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Well, trust in your talent. Stop worrying about everything.
I am not worrying about all these things. I am analyzing everything. I want to express the desert. Take a piece of her and mold it into something that everyone can see clearly. A statement.
You want to mold the desert. Are you still high?
No, I want to manifest what I see when I am here, when I look into the vast openness.
Yeah? And what's that?
Opportunity, expression, freedom. A blank canvas, my friend. Anything is possible here. Anything. Mm-hmm. We can do what we want. We can make art when we want. We can drink when we want. Yeah. Make love when we want.
Yeah.
We can start with a fresh mindset. It's all open. We just have to let the desert pour into our minds.
And you think sculpting Da Vinci's Last Supper with fabric and ghosts, which are supremely creepy, by the way, does all of this for you?
Does the Nevada desert not resemble the Holy Land? It's just the beginning, man. We plant the seed. We put a famous classical piece that everyone knows into a place that no one knows. Don't you see? It's a juxtaposition. The known and the unknown. The duality of man.
Yeah. You're definitely still high.
John!
Oh, hey, here they are.
Hey, dude. Sorry we're late. Had a hell of a time finding this place.
Don't worry. We'll take all of your stuff up to camp when we're done here today.
So, how many days do you think this will take, then?
Why? You have somewhere more important to be? Well, maybe you better leave now if you want to make it on time.
Luke, Tina, this is Albert, the artist.
How's it hanging, man?
How does what hang?
It's just an expression.
Now, why do you Americans have so many expressions?
So, John has told us that you're like this totally rad artist from France.
Belgium.
Okay, yeah, whatever, from across the pond.
So, when are we doing this?
We would have been doing this a half an hour ago.
Okay, well, chill out, man. We're here now. Let's get started.
Okay, fine. Yes, all right, let us begin. But you are getting in the plastic first.
Albert was very fun-loving most of the time, but he did not appreciate people not taking his art or his process seriously. However, nothing could shake Albert's love of the desert and the freedom it represented for him. But not all artists who came out to the desert were as impressed with the landscape and lifestyle as Albert. Let us skip to the future. Fred Bervoets, an expressionist painter and Albert's mentor, knighted in Belgium. He was lovingly nicknamed the Big Gray Baby by Albert. Fred came out to the Nevada desert in 1996 after hearing tales of Albert's success and his Last Supper sculpture. He was one of a handful of artists chosen to come out and put up an installation. However, it wasn't quite what Fred was expecting.
Fred! It's time to get up now. There's work to do, art to make, drinks to drink, and women to talk to, my friend.
Allez, that'll be just fine. I haven't been sleeping at all anyway.
Oh, come on, man. Time for a cold bud and breakfast.
I do not want a cold bud and breakfast. I want my tea like I have at home. Why you have chosen this godforsaken place to put up your art is beyond me.
Oh, come on now. Put on your boots and let's get out in the sunshine.
Yeah, I would put my boots on, Albert. But first I have to check them for snakes and for scorpions and for tarantulas and anything else that would kill me in this desolate place.
I know. Isn't it wonderful?
No, it's not wonderful. It's hot. I am the professor at the Royal Academy of Fine Arts in Antwerp, and now I'm alone, here, suffering in the desert.
You are looking at this the wrong way. You can get up and create whatever art you wish to today out in the sand. No one cares. It is just art. You want to sculpt a bear? A vampire? A portrait of your family? A beautiful naked lady? No one cares. This place is freedom.
I will die here, Albert.
Oh, my dramatic friend. Come on now. Here, grab my hands and let's get you up.
No, I wish to suffer sitting down.
Come on now, you.
No, Albert.
Come.
I am not in the mood for games, Albert.
I'm just in the mood for tears, Albert. I tease. I've had a few breakfast cold buds already, and you'll have to forgive me. Oniva.
Yes, Oniva, Oniva.
Now, back to Albert's original sculpture process and the desert. The days were hot, and the work was sometimes hard, but man, was it an experience.
Maestro, let's begin.
Play the music! All right! Hey, what? Oh, hide!
Oh, God, what is he wearing?
It appears to be a football uniform.
All right, then, safety! Thank you! Are we ready?
Where did you get that?
I can be very resourceful.
Let me rephrase that. Why are you wearing that?
Football! What is more American than football? We are in America. After all, I want the full experience. Luke, are you ready?
I'm still sore from the other molds. It's not easy staying in one position that long. Besides, all that crap weighs like 100 pounds, and I feel like I'm in a sauna wearing all this plastic.
Trivial things. You want to live in infamy, my friend? Well, this is one way of achieving it.
That's fine, but it's Tina's turn next. Before I die of heat stroke.
I'm sorry. I can't hear you.
You're the worst girlfriend ever.
What? I love you too.
John, come here and start laying on this side.
Over here?
Yeah, okay. Okay, and now I want you to turn this way, Luke.
Over here, Luke.
No, not too much.
Come on.
Okay. Now, look at Jesus. Look at him.
Look at Jesus, Luke.
Now, you are Judas, man. Get into it. There you go. Now, don't move.
At this point, I don't think I could move if I wanted to.
Just how I like you.
You're a sadist!
Well, technically, you are Judas, so who is really in the wrong here? Besides, you had better be nice to me, or I won't give you some of my nice, cold beer.
Oh, come on. I'm practically dying of dehydration over here.
Here. Don't say I never did nothing for you.
Yes. What a sacrificing, selfless love I have.
Now stop talking! You are moving too much.
Too much?
I need you to focus here.
Sorry.
Okay. Now we are almost set here. There. That's it. There. Fantastic.
Nice.
All right. Now hold this.
For how long?
Until it is dry, my friend.
Who needs another beer?
Me.
Yes, me too. Now is a good time for a break. Okay. We will be back, Luke.
Wait, what?
You'll be fine. Living in infamy, remember?
Wait, how am I going to get out?
Now, we'll be back for you. Have a nice cold bud waiting for you.
Wait, guys? Hey, guys!
Hello?
The molds were quite a process, and could be very tedious. The weighted fabric could add up to 150 pounds, and the highs in August could reach over 100 degrees in rhyolite. The models had to be wrapped in plastic and had to hold the same pose for at least 20 minutes so the mold could dry. Any slight movement could crack the mold, and the whole process would have to start all over again. While we wait for our models to dry, shall we skip ahead to the future and check in on our friend Fred Bervoets? When Fred and Albert weren't arguing about Fred's impending demise in the desert, they did like to enjoy conversation, over a cold bud, of course.
What is wrong with you?
You have been my mentor long enough. If anyone knows what's wrong with me, it would be you.
Well, I can't believe you had brought me here.
Well, you could be a little bit more thankful, Alay.
Yes, I will be thankful in a few days when I am gone. Hand me that brush.
You know they frown at defacing public property here. I don't think they will like you painting on their bar.
Defacing? I am making this shithole better.
And what is it you are painting? Oh, no. What sad faces? So many tears.
It looks like Hieronymus Bosch's work, no?
Yes, in a very dark way. Hand me a brush. If you are determined to make your misery visual, I will help.
Fine. Something we can agree on.
The Last Supper.
What?
The Last Supper. Now, I know you are wanting to know why I chose that piece.
With you, Albert, I've learned to wait it out. Like the tide, you will come in when you are ready.
I've wanted to sculpt it for a while.
But why here?
Because how many Last Suppers were had here?
In this bar? Probably quite a bit. Probably crawling with rats and diseases.
Oh, this town, most of Nevada for that fact, is built on the idea of Last Suppers. The boom and the bust. The Last Supper before striking it rich. The Last Supper before moving on to a different location to try and stay alive. The literal Last Supper of any man who dared to work in the danger of the mine. We all have Last Suppers, my friend. Last Suppers of marriages, of dreams, of love affairs. Many things do not last, and we should honor that. And this town, Rhyolite, represents that for me, at least in the beginnings.
We all have Last Suppers. I hate it when you're so goddamn smart. Too bad that Antwerp couldn't have represented that for you. We'd find ourselves in a much more pleasant environment.
Belgium is too full of bureaucracy. I mean, you want to create something, it takes months before you can even start. And once you get through all the red tape, you don't even know why you wanted to start it in the first place. This place is where I want to be.
Albert, the brainless Belgian in the desolate desert.
Albert, the adopted American in the dreaming desert.
Well, it does seem that your little project has gone over well here. I don't think it's going anywhere for a while. At least they have taught you well.
Yeah, I suppose you have. I will be sure to thank you first when I become the most famous artist in the world.
Well, except your painting is still shit.
The Last Supper of my painting career.
Yes. Well, you must eat it up then.
Now, let us reflect on some of the more comedic parts of Albert's life as an artist. In 1994, Albert's first exhibit around his Last Supper sculpture was at hand. Suzanne Hackett Morgan, a woman who would eventually become one of his closest friends, organized the exhibit in Las Vegas for him. However, things did not quite go according to plan.
Suzanne, are we ready to open the doors? Let all my biggest fans in to meet me?
Yes, Albert. Let me get the hors d'oeuvres first. Where did you put them?
They are in the back.
Okay, let me grab them real quick. Albert, what is this? What have you done to this watermelon?
I have made it a masterpiece.
You stuck all the chicken skewers in it. It looks like a deformed porcupine.
People will love it.
If you say so.
Hello? I'm looking for Albert Szukalski's exhibit. Hello?
Albert, you didn't unlock the door.
Allez. A minor setback. Hold on. John! So good of you to make it.
You know I wouldn't miss it.
Oh, John, let me introduce you to Suzanne Hackett Morgan. Now, her official title is the Savior of Sculpture, or something like that.
It's the Save the Outdoor Sculpture Coordinator. Hi, I'm Susan.
Nice to meet you. I'm John. So you organized this whole thing?
Yes, figured it was about time that Albert had a meet and greet about his exhibit.
Hello? Is anyone in there?
Luke, stop it. You sound like the police.
Albert, you have to keep the door unlocked if you want people to be able to get in.
Unlocked, locked, just phrases. Luke, Dina, so good to see you. It has been so long.
It has been too long.
We came to see all your fans. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Yes, they will be busting down the door any minute. Let me introduce you to Susan. This is Susan, the grand orchestrator of this event. Susan, this is Luke and Tina.
You helped model for the molds, right?
Yes, we...
Well, I did most of the modeling. Well, I mean, I did the important characters at least. Jesus, Judas...
Oh, here we go again.
Oh, sorry, I didn't get to stand around all day and drink beer, John.
Yes, you did.
Well, okay, but in between that, I did do the majority of the modeling.
Okay, stop it, you two. Today is about Albert.
This brings back so many fond memories. I'm sure all the adoring fans would love these stories.
Albert, what is that?
What?
The abomination that's sitting on that table.
It was supposed to be a watermelon.
My God, it's both horrendous and beautiful.
Thank you, my friend.
So, Susan, how long have you known Albert?
Just a little while, but he has made quite the impression.
Yes, Susan and I have already had many adventures together. Would you like to hear a poem we wrote together the other night?
Sure.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, come on. It's great.
You're not going to win this one, Susan. May as well proceed.
Okay, so this one is called An Exquisite Corpse. Are you ready?
Yes. 16, on beds humble and unreluctant as sponges.
Chicken lips for dinner.
Baby, I die in slow, cold sips, feather-tongued then.
Canadian Indians as neighbors.
This secret melt. A graduate degree, Canterbury, Barry.
Cream cheese on a melted plane.
When the work is done, don't you hope for heat. Here.
The sacrifice that never existed.
Look, girlfriend, it's all so much radio as Yoko.
A meteor in my household.
Tree man, pirate mounted, wicked, ha! A Californian.
It's like taking a brain for a bath. What do you think? It's good, no?
In your own words? It's fantastic.
Thank you. Written over one of many cold buds.
Speaking of cold buds...
In the back.
Thanks.
So, this thing started at 6, right?
Yes. People are probably just running late.
I'm sure they are.
Well, who wouldn't?
Damn it, Albert, unlock that door.
Locked, unlocked. Hello, welcome to my art exhibit. No doubt you are here to meet me, Albert Szukalski.
Oh, sorry, wrong address.
Unfortunately, Albert's first exhibit was not what he expected. His fame and reputation with his work in the Nevada desert didn't reach its peak until later in his career. But much like the ghosts in the desert, that night became very memorable for those involved. As for the other artists recognized at the open-air museum, they did manage to leave their marks as well. Our friend Fred Bervotz, the Big Gray Baby, was one such artist. Fred made a giant sculpture of a miner and a penguin called Tribute to Shorty Harris, one of the prospectors who led the gold rush in Rhyolite in 1904. And the penguin... Well, you will find out. Fred and Albert stand in front of Fred's finished masterpiece.
So, this is your piece?
Yes.
Fantastic! A miner! And a penguin.
Yes.
It is quite large. I am impressed. It must be 20 feet high. So what does it mean?
What does it mean? Huh. Well... The cowboy is Shorty Harris, the man who founded this wonderful town.
Okay. And the penguin?
The penguin is me, Albert.
I'm not following.
Me, Albert, me. It's what? Me. I'm the penguin. It is me.
What?
It's an Arctic bird stuck in the middle of this goddamn heat and sand and barren wasteland.
Well, that is certainly one way to make a statement.
Yes. We see the miner. He belongs here. We see he loves it here, but the penguin does not and wishes to go home. Voila!
I cannot... This is probably your best piece you have ever done! What a statement! This is one that will last the ages.
Good. Then it can stay in the Nevada desert while I travel back home.
Yes, Master Penguin! Let's get you ready for your trip back home.
And indeed, Fred went home and never did return to the desert. However, his statement of loneliness and feeling out of place still does have a lasting impact today. He had an exhibit in Antwerp based on his experiences in Nevada. Another artist in Rhyolite also left a lasting impact. In 1992, another of Albert's Belgian contemporaries, Dr. Hugo Herrmann, came out and built the Lady Desert, the Venus of Nevada.
Hey, Albert, don't you knock? This is my workspace. I need total concentration.
Sorry to interrupt, but here, catch this.
And what is this?
More fan mail for you.
Huh. More American prudes, you mean.
Listen, I think it is great. But you did build a giant naked lady with blonde hair everywhere, my friend.
She is the Venus of Nevada. No one cares when there are naked Greek statues. This one just happens to be made out of cinder blocks. It's about the melding of the ancient ideas of art with the emerging computer technology. I'm telling you, technology will soon take over.
Oh, I believe you. But maybe it's a true fan letter. And the odds are that you are bound to get at least one.
I don't think so.
Oh, come on, open it. Let's hear some good news.
Oh, good news, indeed. Ha! Into the garbage it goes.
We are in Vegas after all. Let's try our luck. Dear Mr. Hugo, your art is truly one of a kind. You are an inspiration to all artists everywhere.
Ah, now, what does it really say?
Mr. Hugo, you are a pervert.
Ha! And there it is!
They will come around.
I agree. I have written a poem about Our Lady Venus. Would you like to hear it?
An artist and a poet.
Mm-hmm.
You never cease to surprise me, my friend. Yes, please, recite.
Lady Desert, the Venus of Nevada. I'm the darling of digital space. A 3D model of reality, sharing my feelings with the magical desert, showing my naked body to the virtual future. In my dream time, I'm feeling the heat of the light on my yellow hair, on my naked body, on my square breasts, turning around with the world. Not afraid of being myself. I'm the Venus of Nevada, inventing the colors of joy, sharing my interactive memory and my background of love with all living things. Traveler, say goodbye to my system and move on.
Well,
what do you think?
Fantastic. Yeah, I think... more people will come to love your pink, naked lady.
She's the Venus
yes,
of Nevada.
Yes, yes, yes. The Venus of Nevada. The very pink and the very naked Venus of Nevada, but Venus nonetheless.
Back in 1984, Albert had just a few more loose ends to finish up, and then his Last Supper masterpiece would be complete. However, the impending thought of leaving what he considered to be paradise weighed on him.
Hey, Maestro. You have a phone call.
Really? I wonder who could it be? Maybe it is the President of the United States calling to tell me what a star I am.
Oh, take it easy, Tom Cruise.
Yes, well, I won't keep him waiting.
Hey, who was that?
I don't know. Some chick with an accent. I think her name was Frida? Rita?
Rita?
Yeah. Why? Who is that?
His patron. The person who's fronting all the money for his wild art project. Oh, hey, Luke.
Hey, guys. Do you know what's going on? Albert's yelling at someone on the phone down there.
We don't know.
Yeah, he's like down there yelling in Italian or whatever.
He's not Italian. Like, at all.
Maybe we're overreacting. Maybe he's just really excited on the phone.
Well, hopefully. It's good news. Not good news.
That was quick. Is everything all right?
No, everything is not all right.
What's going on?
Rita just called to tell me that my visa expires soon and I have to go back right after the unveiling. Can you believe it?
Oh, man. I'm so sorry, Albert.
This is horseshit! This is where I want to be. Why can't I be here? I hate Belgium! Everyone is in everyone's business. There are too many rules and there are too many people!
Can you do anything about it?
No. I have to go back or I will be deported and then I can never come back.
Well, you can come back, right?
Yes, but only for a few weeks a year.
Don't worry. We can try and figure something out. You just have to play by the rules until we can think of something.
I just feel like it is always going to be this way, that I will never be able to be where I want.
It's okay, Albert. We won't let you leave here forever. You belong out here. You're the Da Vinci of the desert. Now, how about a nice cold bud? I know I could use one.
Yes. That will do. For now.
Putting bad news aside, the day of the unveiling and dedication finally arrived in Rhyolite. The media and press were all there to witness the dedication. This was the moment Albert was waiting for.
He should be here any minute.
Who are we waiting for again?
The mayor.
Oh, the Vegas mayor is coming?
No, the mayor of Rhyolite.
Of Rhyolite? Who elected him? The boroughs?
No, John, the only ass here is you.
Well, he better get here soon. All this press and paparazzi people are making me uncomfortable.
Here he comes.
Nice to meet you, Albert. I'm Mayor Jim Spencer, and this is Julia, a representative of the Lieutenant Governor's office.
Nice to meet you.
You ready to begin?
Of course.
Hello, and welcome, everyone. I would like to introduce you to a very fascinating and talented individual. Albert Szukalski. I have to admit that I believed his project was a little bizarre and out of left field initially. However, I think the town is going to have a lot of potential in the future due to Albert's work here. Rhyolite is the perfect location for his talent. It is scenic, and the location is close to metropolitan areas like Las Vegas and Los Angeles. We hope to have many more fascinating projects like this in the future. Now I would like to introduce you to Julia Barber, a representative from the Lieutenant Governor's office, here to present a letter to Albert.
Thank you, and thank all of you for joining us here today. Dear Mr. Szukalski, I am joined with those gathered here this afternoon to honor you and your assistant at the unveiling of your unique creations depicting Christ's Last Supper. We in Nevada are honored at your selection of Rhyolite to display your latest creation. Nevada means many things to many people, and how fortunate for us that during your travels last year you saw in our desert a resemblance to the Holy Land. We appreciate your marvelous gift to us and know all who have the opportunity to view it will be spiritually affected by the experience. I would hope that in return you will take with you our gratitude, our hospitality, and feeling that through your gift you've become one of us. Respectfully, Lieutenant Governor.
Thank you, Julia.
Oh.
In Belgium, we always kiss three times.
Albert, on behalf of the city of Rhyolite, I want to give you this certificate, making you an honorary citizen of the city of Rhyolite in recognition of your contribution here.
Fantastic!
That was one of the happiest days of Albert's whole life. Not only had he completed his sculpture, but he was, by every manner, an American. Albert's Last Supper sculpture had led the way for more diverse art in Rhyolite. Albert frequented back to Rhyolite every summer on his visa while he could, but as with art, not everything lasts forever. And even the best stories must come to an end. In 2000, Albert was hospitalized in Belgium as he was losing his battle with throat cancer, with me by his side. My love, how are you feeling?
I could use a cigarette and a cold bud.
I know, but you know you can't have that.
Then Hand me the sheets. I wish to finish one more sculpture while I can.
Do not talk like that. You will be okay. Here, take these sheets. And what shall we name this one?
The Lady of Mercy.
The Lady of Mercy?
I wish to name it Monique. Lady of Mercy. My muse. My love. I wish you to look at it and know how much I love you.
I know how much you love me. Look who is here. Your friend John has come all the way out here to see you.
Hi, Albert. You look like shit.
John, my friend, you always have had a way with words. I'm so glad to see you.
I am too, Albert.
How is my desert?
It's good, but it's not the same without you. It misses you.
And I miss it. How are our friends, Luke and Dina?
They're well. They wanted me to tell you hello and that they miss you. We're all waiting on our next big desert reunion. However, Luke promises to not be on time, just to piss you off.
That bastard!
Are you okay? Are you okay?
Just breathe.
I am fine. I just need a little rest.
Now. Close your eyes, my love, and try to relax. I want you to imagine your desert. Imagine yourself there, with the heat on your back and the horizon open to you.
Yes.
Just relax and imagine you are home.
Judas.
Albert Szukalski passed away on January 25th, 2000. In his final hours, he called Suzanne Hackett Morgan and urged her to keep the museum and the work going. She is now the director of the Goldwell Open Air Museum and has stayed true to her word. Albert's love for America and for the freedom that the Nevada desert represented to him lives on through his work and through the other artists who frequent the Goldwell Open Air Museum and Rhyolite. He was truly the maestro of human expression in the wild desert.
My name is Albert Szukalski, and this is my America, man.
Albert Szukalski's America. Written and directed by Emily Anderson. Starring Scott Glennon, Lane Bartlett, Caleb Tapia, Elena Monson, DJ McCoy, and Cameron Eden. Special thanks to Elko Broadcasting Company.